Welcome back to the Fuller Fanatic channel. Today, I will be sharing what I believe to be Reate'S best production. It's the Evo Typhoon, designed by Brian Nadeau. Starting with the aesthetics, there's nothing on the market that quite looks like the tie. Very subtle details, such as the pivot style choice, an integrated rear spacer with jimping, all working in unison to bring this build together. Inside this awesome build is where a majority of its innovation can be found. The most notable being the fact the build doesn't use a traditional detent ball. Instead, the design utilizes a detent nub, often referred to as the Nadeau Nubb, resulting in a much smoother and consistent action. Not to mention, occasionally detent balls wear down over time and become loose or pop out. By using the nub, the performance is increased. In addition to, this eliminates a potential point of failure on the build. Another visually pleasing aspect about the Typhoon is the lack of body screws. This being the 2020 release, yes, many builds have minimal and in some cases no hardware exposed, but the Typhoon's first production run was in 2017, I believe. Meaning, the tie looked this way back when many productions had four or more exposed screws on its show side alone. And I say all that to say the tie was way before its time. As to the countless internal feats pulled off by this design, I'll begin with the captured washers. Unlike every other build I've personally witnessed, this one has a lip around a milled pocket that accepts the washers. Then, each washer has been notched, so it locks into place, preventing a free spin. I've had some builds where due to the design and simply physics, plus a bit of oil, a washer can stick to your cage bearings, just as they stick to the milled wall when lubricated, and in fact, be doing the rotating instead of the bearings. I mentioned the nubbed detent, which isn't the only one on the market, but it's the first one I was made aware of, and the only one I've seen in a Reate'S production. The nub has its own integrated detent ramp, which makes for a very seamless transition between disengagement and shifting the detent over and onto the blade's face. And I spoke to the build's lack of exposed hardware, but the fact is, some builds hide the screws and do this very well, but the Typhoon simply just doesn't have them. Utilizing the same hole used to mount the pocket clip, the screw doubles as a body screw, which other than the pivot, is the only body screw holding the entire frame together. And as to the half spade flipper tab, I've heard many people say it's a boot heel or it's very extreme, but for me, it's not a big issue. And furthermore, it fires hard, consistently, and every time. And I've yet to slip off or fail a deploy with either push button or light switch methods. Now this is the Tonto blade shape with a harpoon switch and a compound grind. The tip has a flat grind while the flat edge is a hollow grind. And in the case of both grinds, this is the thinnest edge I've seen come from the Reate'S factory. The Typhoon has a second means of deploy, the beautiful full-length fuller that on many videos I've watched, people have said you cannot use the fuller for deployment. To be honest, the usable fuller area isn't located in a position that a user would think. I customized this tie by polishing the fuller and hardware, this previously being an all blacked out version, which I removed the coating from the handle as well. And if you follow the channel, you know if it's mine, I'm going to definitely make it one of a kind. And this being a production run, it's a bit smaller than the full custom. This one coming in with an overall length of 8 1/4 inches and a blade length of 3 3/4 inches. And without internal milling, this knife only weighs 4 ounces. When knives this size usually clock in around 5.5 ounces, this flipper is lightweight in my opinion. And this is not so much an overview, but my reason as to why I honestly believe this to be Reate'S best production to date. And let me know you all's thoughts on the subject down below. And with that, I'll be signing off from the Fuller Fanatic.